What is up, everyone? We are on a brand new segment called Climbing the Ladder. Now, I'm going to try climb my way from bronze, silver, platinum, diamond, master, challenger. Now, I'm currently in already silver 4 with 69 LP right now. Now, I'm going to try by the end of the season to at least get to platinum. I know it doesn't sound like much, but for platinum for me would be ecstatic. So this whole entire video segment, series, what you call it, is all about you, the fans, teaching me what to do. As far as if I'm doing something bad, call me out on it. You know, leave a like, leave a comment, anything like that. Just, you know, call me out, say what I can get better, and help me climb. We'll do it together. So I listed a few things that I want to keep in mind. So first of all, have fun. That's the thing I need to remember, that this is just a game, but I want to climb higher and I want to have fun doing it with you guys. Next off is stay positive. Now, it's kind of the same thing as having fun. However, in game, something can go wrong, get frustrated, everything like that. And you have to stay positive in order to get that win. So next we have do our best. So we can do this. We can do our best just in lane as a person, so we know that we did the best that we can and not blame our other team or anything like that. If we lose, so what? We know that we did our best and that's all that matters. So the fourth one is do not tilt. And it's kind of the same thing as stay positive and do your best, because you know, if you tilt yourself or anything like that, that can affect other games, and that you don't want that to happen. Or you can affect other people by spamming a chat or anything like that. So, next up, we have positioning. Now, this is kind of the macro play that I want to kind of remember in my head, positioning. Now, I'm trying to get better at positioning. Currently, I'm in mid ADC kind of roles right now. So, I'll try to get better on my positioning. But if you have any, you know, comments or anything like that, or tips, let me know as far as positioning. So, next up, what does the other player look like? So I'm talking about, this is mostly laning phase. You know, 1, 2, all the way up to 6. What does the other player look like? A lot of the time I have a hard time with understanding, you know, can I go in? Can I kill this person? You know, does he have higher level than me? Does he have more items than me? What's his mana look like? Or even his health? You know, as far as if I understand what the other player looks like, then I could have a possibility of, you know, winning those trades and winning the lane and everything like that, getting more gold and pushing my objectives more. So next, downtime. There's a lot of downtime between, you know, mid or early mid and late game. You know, what can you be doing? Taking towers, taking objectives, taking dragons, barons, even, you know, jungle camps, things like that. You can always be doing something to further yourself along, and I need to remember that. If you have an idea of what I could be doing on my downtime or anything like that, or even if I'm just, you know, being retarded and not doing what I should be, or even looking, hey, it's downtime, I need to push something, you know, let me know what you think. And next off, probably the most important one, don't die, or try not to die. I think my KDA is getting a little bit better, but I'm going to try to get better at it. And, you know, I think that has a lot to do with positioning. And so if we do that, then we should be just fine. All right, let's crack to it and let's play League of Legends Climbing the Ladder. All right, we're getting the match set up right now. Yeah, it should be interesting. Like I said, I've been doing mostly playing ADC right now. Was a jungler for the longest time. Then I know junglers are in season 7. I know they're carrying pretty hard, but right now I don't think I'm as strong of a jungler as I am a mid laner or ADC. Topped for a long time, but just in solo queue, for some reason I feel not really strong in top lane. So let's just try out mid lane and ADC can do. Mostly I've been doing Orianna and Varus mid end. So it should be kind of interesting to see. So, but like I said, leave a like, leave a comment, everything like that. I'd love to hear from you guys. Tell me what I'm doing wrong. Tell me what I'm doing right. just help me try to get to platinum. And it looks like we have a match. We got mid lane, first pick. So it's kind of safe to say I don't get any choice of picking or anything like that. So, you know, safe to say I'm going to play Orianna and hope for the best. I don't want to be a one-trick pony, but at the same time, I got to go with something I'm good at. With these type of mastery, everything's okay.
It's your funeral.
Looks like it. Okay. Now, if my rune pages or anything like that don't look good, call me out on it. Say what
you
used
to be cool.
Love to hear it. So, now I've kind of been running in this elo. It's been really working out as far as, you know, remove snares, remove traps.
A true hunter never
rests. It removes all of that.
Do not deny me.
And I said, don't die as much. Yeah, it's been good. Ban so far, Echo, Zed, their side, Yorick and Rengar are strong this patch. Looking like a J4 and a rank 4 Fort and jungle. Should be pretty strong. We're already
angry.
And they banned our Orianna. Really? Dang it. Okay. So it looks like their first pick. After that, I've been doing Lux. Corki's really well. We have a fully damagey team, so anything damage would be nice. I thought about maybe going Ryze, Cassiopeia, everything like that. I've been doing okay with both. So, and it looks like they're taking Blitzcrank off the table for our team. So, Yasuo is not banned. Kind of makes me a little nervous. But you know, I gotta go with what I'm good at, and I like this the Ryze idea.
A step ahead of Cataclysm.
Now I probably won't cleanse on this one. I'll probably just go standard Flash and Ghost. I just don't think it's really necessary for Ryze. But we'll see who they pick. It'll be interesting. Let's crank in this elo. Very hard. Like I just said. And Yasuo mid. I haven't won against the Yasuo in a long time because he's usually permabanned. So it'll be interesting. You know, gotta stay positive though. How can we beat a Yasuo? You know, his win wall is so strong, especially since our whole entire kit revolves around poking damage. Everything like that. But if I can bait it out the spell, if I can bait out the spell shield, then I should be fine, and I should be able to go okay. Because I do have that point click season. I can use. Looking like so far they have a really tanky team. As far as the Cho'Gath, Blitzcrank, everything like that. But then they have the high damage with the Graves, with the Misfortune, with Yasuo. I'm assuming the knockup with the Yasuo and the Cho'Gath, they might be duoing together, which is not bad, you know, fine. Especially because of the buffs with Cho'Gath. Be okay. For their part. Now, our part, the nice thing is we do have a lot of tank with Jarvan and Shen. Which will be nice. Another thing that we have is the gonna be interesting. So we'll see how it goes. Yeah. See how it's gonna go. A little scared, but like I said, you gotta stay positive. You gotta thinking constantly of what to do. So, like I said, looks like Shannon and Jarvan are gold players last season. Like I said, last season I've been silver, I've been bronze, and this season I am to get into platinum. So, if we can do it, starting off. The Lulu is going to be nice just because of the engage that they have, especially with the Yasuo and the Graves. It'll be nice. Ryze is a late scaling champion, so I feel like if later on it goes, later we should be okay. However, the Cho'Gath is the same late scaling champion. It'll be interesting. I'm excited to see what Sivir does, however, because I think that our team has more of productive clearing. But, you know, like I said, if I'm splurting out just babble, let me know. Talk. I'd love to get better at Legends. The micro things I could get better at.
Make this quick.
Okay, so we're going to start off basic kind of Ryze build. Sapphire Crystal with health potion. I did take the biscuits.
Funk,
tell me. Like it.
Worthy of my
task. So we're probably gonna start with our Q first. Just the overload.
30 seconds until
I'm probably looking for an invade right now. They have the blitz rank. Not gonna be fun. Like I said, good positioning. I should be able to mitigate a lot of that blitz pull if he does roam up to mid. Like I got a ward right there from Graves. Got Lulu just laughing hysterically. Okay. Turn around, Sivir. One thing I've been doing a lot, and I've heard that Doublelift does this, is muting everyone. I've been doing this for quite a while now. And it helps me. It helps me for being tilted. It helps from toxic.
By will.
So let's try to bully this.
Civilization. I remember when I was a.
Let's see. Play this, yeah.
I'll find it you dance on.
He hit me.
They know so little of the world they traverse. Leave now. I read the room. You lose.
Should be interesting. Like I said, it'll be. It'll be interesting. If my trades can go decent, then I should be able to. Do okay with it. But, you know. Like I said, it'll have to be a lot of me poking him back and forth, drawing out that spell shield, and then, going after that. There's the spell shield. Pop him out. Yeah, it's gonna be interesting that I haven't played Ryze in a little bit just because I've been playing Thunderlord's proc. I've just been playing Orianna a lot, so it should be. Like I said, I don't know how many times I can say anything. Interesting. I can farm better. We got a miss things mid.
You wanna help?
J4 right there. That'd be interesting. I'm beating him in CS, however he's. He's beating me. He's poking me out pretty hard. And See how it goes. If I can get more tanky, then I might be able to, you know, hold my own again. But he's just, right now he's a lot of games up. So So, Ignite is down. Ignite down. But he tried to get it out of me. I am gonna miss this creep wave right here, but going back for my tier is gonna be nice. How's everybody else? Level 5 to level 4. They just backed, and I mean, considering that our Shen's out farming.
Every rune I find is another day.
Like I said, if I can do,
are you following me?
If I can hold my own and not die, bot. That's the key. I cannot die a lot, then I think I should be. And if I'm leveling up anything that I shouldn't or should be going for first or anything like that, let me know. Okay, so we got Graves coming in the mid lane. And he is just zoning me out, so I can't get any of my minions, which is what he should be doing. I play that really poorly. Yeah, really poorly. So, Graves was mid, everything like that, and I didn't stun Graves. I should have when he hit me just because the tower hits. It'll be interesting. Who got the kill? Oh, yeah. Okay. That kind of sucks, but see how our other team.
Blessing or curse.
So what I could have done better is, like I said, maybe gone out a little bit more when I saw Graves coming in. Then okay, so he hit level 6 already. Okay, so he misplayed that and dove me under tower thinking that he would kill me with Ignite, but he didn't, which is nice. We got a kill. That's F up. I have been playing, like I said, a bit weird as far as I shouldn't have. Should have been clicking. Should have been
fast and lean. That's how
managing my abilities. Shen's doing really well against Cho'Gath, which is good. Now, if he dies under tower, I don't know what's gonna happen. Our bot lane, our Sivir's out farming Misfortune, very nice. So, I think there is a control ward in here. He's probably gonna come in on me. Okay, so we know that Graves is off. So we got Blitzcrank.
Blessing
couldn't do much right there. I should have been fighting back. I should have been casting my abilities while running or kiting them back. See, that is nice of, you know, a Blitzcrank or anything like that that can get those early pull, get those early kills for their team. So nice, got double kill, and then should be able to get out. I think he might get dove. I might roam top. Oh, there's not much I can do if I go top. But he sees me coming. Yeah, see, my abilities are just not, my cooldowns are not there yet, and sucks. However, our top lane's doing good, 2-0, junglers 1-0. I've been dying a lot, and I need to remember to stop dying a lot. So what I can do to not die a lot, better position. This creep score is raping mine to the ground. Not too. Okay, so we got mid lane pushing in. Definitely doing more tower damage, which is nice. So my wave is pushing, so I'm gonna try to ward. See if we can get some deep. He is pushing in pretty. Wave pushing in pretty heavily. Just once. It's going along. They did do this, so that was a little scary. Away. So, that was good. That was good. Nice trade. And now he should have backed, but he's roaming bot. Roaming bot, really shouldn't have anything. But Graves was in their blue upside. So looks like he's going top lane. And shit. Okay, so a lot of this has to do with Yasuo just a lot. I know that he's basically, he'll get in close and then he'll throw up his wall and then try to just go all in. So I might have to use that to my advantage. Now I didn't know that Shen or that Yasuo was top lane. Yeah. Okay, so Shen comes up in 10. I think he still has his TP up, but then at the same time, yeah, he's telling me not to go. So, you know what? I won't go. So I am running low on mana, and he is probably going to back top lane. So I am going to back as well. Buy some of this. I need the need the cooldowns. So hopefully I can get that 1-2 punches back. Got 4-2, 1-3. So I think I need to start roaming a little bit as far as helping out my top laner. Top laner is the better one. Other than our AD. So, let's try it.
I am just a vessel. I may fail, but I won't quit.
So we got the war, we got the So we realmed ward, but we needed that kill anyways. So either way. Definitely hurt. Definitely hurts. Was not expecting that out of there. Get that shutdown gold. See, another thing is too, that now that I'm thinking about it, I really can't take it back, is I should have bought Rod of Ages first. At least for the health against Oswo.
I can tell you what's on this scroll. But then I have to obliterate you.
But you know, we'll see what we can do. We'll build that next. I know we're building a Marilla Nomicon just because of the cooldowns, but like I said, if I'm doing something wrong, please just tell me.
They have forgotten the fire that forged this world.
Got Misfortune already. Yeah. So our Sivir is doing extremely well again. So that's good. They still out farm me. That, but see what we can do. We got Graves over a dragon. Getting the Scuttle Crab. It looks like he's trying to come in for a fight. Or at least ward up because dragon is within a few. So let's do. I have no vision down there at all, and it looks like 5 bot lane. So,
if I fall,
the only thing I can do is push out my mid lane, and go on this side because I have a ward.
They come for the scroll.
Got a flash over. Sucks, but
none are worthy of my task.
Burn my ghost as well. And I don't see Blitzcrank. Okay, so there he is. So seeing Blitzcrank, I know that not gonna come through the jungle, kill me. Now, where's the other person at? Like I've been saying, the other person, level 12. Which is god awful. So he's level 12. I'm level 10. I gotta keep my levels up. So what can I be doing? Getting jungle kin. Could be roaming a little bit better. Everything like that. So Graves was down in this area before. Let's see. Can't do anything down here. They're pushed really high. really far up. And Yasuo's roaming. Yasuo's roaming, and hoping that Shen gets out. So it looks like they're roaming into their blue buff. So looks like he's got a lot of damage out of that. But I do have three mid that I saw. So three mid, not gonna go well. Looks like it went decently. I can't do anything against the Cho'Gath. Get that kill. Realm Warp over to here. Okay, they don't want me to chase, so I'm not going to. Did get a lot out of that. So that was good. That was very good. Got a lot out of that. I'm gonna push out mid lane. Push out mid lane. Maybe back. Do have 2,100 gold, so I should back. Buy at least my Royal Anomicon, and then probably start on my Rod of Ages. I feel horrible buying it this late. Text. Unuseful. It sucks, but I do. Looks like my control ward's still there, so I'm going to buy some bots. Go down. So hopefully he can't. I wouldn't dive. So he got our tower pretty damn fast. Sucks, but like I said, I'm getting better and I'm gonna help.
An enemy has been slain.
And you guys are gonna help me.
Your team has destroyed a turret.
And Sivir's gonna let me die. All right. I shouldn't have went in there just because I knew J4 was going to at least die or at least be really low health. I couldn't do too much. That was my position. Like I said, I'm getting better, and I'm going to try to get better just because I'm playing really sucky right now. You guys are going to help me get better. Okay, so what can we be doing now? It's kind of transition mid-game. Right now, we have two towers. They have one tower. It looks like they're wanting to just A-ram the whole thing, which is not really the best. We do really need this dragon. And it would be nice to get a dragon. It's going to be hard because they have two dragons. They have the better position. And they just got blue buff.
The wise seek to contain power.
They got Scuttle. It looks like they're trying to go after.
I care about these more.
They're going after blue buff. So, I got a TP in. It looks like they're going to, at least we're going to trade a tower or so. Hoping. I'm faster than him. But I got out. Now, Sivir, on the other hand, did not get out. We got second tier turret over on top lane. Oh, good. However, they're going to get this dragon. He killed Graves. Damn. I don't know where they're at, so I'm not going to venture into our blue side. So, don't know where they're at. Go back, heal up, and hopefully.
Trust no one, especially those who seek power.
Yas was pretty fed. Gonna get another kill. I'm surprised he didn't go in on that little bully. I think he can still take J4 even. Big wave bot. I'm hoping that I can get all of it.
I've heard entire nations.
Yeah, like I said, I mean, he's just really fed. Don't know where Graves is.
Civilization.
Pretty sure they have this side warded, so they know that I'm coming this way. We have good around our area warding. However, no, we don't have any deep wards or anything like that. So, we had to disengage because Graves, like I said, was in that area, the jungle. I shouldn't have been playing more up. Just because I didn't know where Graves was. Graves is one of those champions in this type of patch that apparently it's just really snowball-y really fast. So, kill lane or kill bush. Think about Blitzcranks.
An enemy has been slain.
So right now we're winning in objectives as far as towers. We're not winning in dragons. Not winning in kills. Pretty sure it's safe to say we have 4,000 to 5,000 gold deficit. Our Shen is not when the whole entire team comes in. No, it's just pretty rough, but it looks like he is gonna get out. Nice. Can't really do very much. They have a lot more people than we do.
They have forgotten the fire that forged this.
Don't know where anybody else. He's out farming me pretty much by a lot. We'll see how it goes. Like I said, it would have been nice to actually play Orianna. Just because that's what I've been playing most. Nice to ban a Yas. If I would have got a ban, I would have banned you. So, they took Baron. 28-minute Baron. Pretty nice. And then our support... Oh, got out. Nice. Our support got out. They're pushing up mid lane pretty heavily. And I don't think we're going to be able to get there without dying.
Yeah.
I have to go the long way. And I can't do it. Yeah, I really think that... Yeah, it was a bust. I really think that the Orianna would have been better. And not. Ouch. Would have been rough. It is rough. But that's League of Legends, where you don't win every time. But you have to get better. And from what I've been seeing, I haven't been getting better. But, staying positive, they did not end the game. So they didn't end the game. What can we do to come back? I'm building this Rod of Ages really late. Sucks! But, yeah. I think I'm just going to have to start building as best as I can. They got an inhib. They got Baron. Push Baron. They're going to get this next dragon. Everything like that. Really sucks.
One can only hold all this power for so long.
Really sucks that they got dragon. Or got Baron. And it looks like they're coming straight for us. And Lulu's sacrificing herself. RJ4 is doing a lot of damage. And I feel bad I can't help him. But at the same time, if I would have went over there, it would have been bad positioning and pretty heavy. So, it looks like right now it is going to be it looks like right now it's going to be 3v and they just melted me. So that's the game. Just really strong. Like I said, it sucks that they banned Orianna, and I'm wondering if that's because they knew they were going to play the Yasuo. And was second pick. First or second. But it was still a good game. They played really good. I didn't play the best that I could. My team played really good. And I know if I played a little bit better, then we could have won. But you know, that's how the game goes. That's how you get better. Learning everything. So, on this defeat, we'll come at you with another game. Leave a like, leave a subscribe, everything like that. Like I said, it sucks that I lost, but at the same time, I understood why I got caught out and why I lost. So, like I said, give me comments, everything like that, that you think that I need to get better at. Micromanage me. Teach me what I should be doing. All right, everyone. Well, thank you very much for watching the first episode of Climbing the Ladder. And I'll get back to you with another episode relatively shortly. Like I said, platinum by the end of the year. All right? See you later, guys. Bye.